tells you to use sunscreen, but what my tip is going to be is what kind of sunscreen you use. It's a magic product, it's brilliant. I'll definitely make a video on how to use a dry shampoo. I have it here in front of me. So this is the Maybelline Baby Lips that I'm talking about. You can just add a touch of blue eyeliner or a blue kajal pencil, and that looks really good in summers. And there are a lot of good face mists available in the market. I have a couple of them here. Hello, welcome to my channel. First of all, thank you so much for the amazing feedback that you all gave me for my last video. I got great comments in the YouTube section as well as messages in my Instagram and Facebook accounts. So thank you so much for all of that, and I promise you I'll be getting a lot of new stuff, new videos on this YouTube channel. So keep watching, you'll get to know a lot of tricks of the trade. Today, since it's summer, I'm going to be talking about summer skincare, makeup and hair care tips that I want to give you all and share with you all. It's insanely hot here in Pune. It's like above 40 degrees for over a week, and for 4-5 days it was above 42 degrees Celsius. So it's crazy hot. People don't want to go outside, and you all can imagine what it is. So since this is going to be talking video, I urge you all to take a cup of coffee or tea and just sit back and listen and relax. So I'll be telling you about a few products also in this video, so try and stock yourself up with the products that I'm telling you, some summer special products that you need to carry in your purse, in your vanity. First tip of summer skincare is definitely going to be drink loads and loads of water. Water is not only obviously good for your body and dehydration, but it does tremendous of benefit to the skin. So your skin is not dehydrated, it looks fresh. It doesn't look that oily if you're drinking water continuously, so definitely drink a lot of water. Second tip is linked to water but a little external. So my second tip is ice. Apply ice on your face every day. This sounds a little funny, but you have to apply ice because A, it closes the pores of your skin. B, it brings down the temperature of your skin, which temporarily, you know, keeps you away from sweating. So it reduces the amount of perspiration on your skin. It also sort of flushes the skin a bit, so your skin looks flushed, it looks fresh. So applying ice on the face helps a lot. At least once a day you should apply ice to your face. If at all you're out and you don't know where to access ice, or if you don't have it accessible, one easy thing you all can follow is wash your face with cold water. That is also one thing you can do, and just splash cold water on your face and you'll just feel energized and fresher and you'll sweat less. So this is my tip number two. Tip number three is of course sunscreen, sunblock. Everyone should use sunscreen. Sunblock is what is talked about and everybody tells you to use sunscreen, but what my tip is going to be is what kind of sunscreen you use. There are so many sunscreens in the market, so what I want you all to read on your sunscreen packaging is it should not be a sunscreen cream, it shouldn't be too oily. So try and find out sunscreens which are lotions. So try to find out sunscreens which are more moisture based than oil based, because already your skin is going to be sweaty and oily. It tends towards being oily even if otherwise you have a normal skin. So try and use sunscreens which are less oily. My favorite sunscreen is Nutrogena. I don't have it right now in front of me, but I swear by Nutrogena, and I love the sunblock that it gives, it the protection that it gives. So Neutrogena is, I really like it. But I have a few sunscreens here with me. This is Lakme Sun Expert. It's a light feel lotion. It's called UV lotion. I also have this one with me, which is Lakme Ultra Matte Lotion. If you can guess from the packaging, this one is little more liquidy in its consistency. So I prefer this to be used on the face if at all you're going to use it. Then I have this Garnier Sun Control with me. So this is like a moisturizer with some UV control, and so what they say is daily moisturizer with SPF. So this is also quite good. Try and use sunblocks which are moisturizer consistency or lotion consistency. So again, that's my tip for your sunscreen. I personally do not use a sunscreen on my face because my face is already too oily. I also avoid using moisturizers in summer. I just wash my face a number of times and I maybe apply a primer. So that's about it. So if your skin is too oily or if your skin tends to sweat a lot, especially on the face, you can completely avoid the sunscreen. That's your choice. Another thing what you should do is use a primer. If you're not going to use a sunscreen and or a moisturizer, you can use a primer because primers have this oil control tendency, which is oil control capacity or quality, which is really good, especially in summers. And also they have some silicone in them, so skin looks smoother and fresher. So I definitely recommend primers. Choose a good brand of primer, try it on your skin, see whether you know it suits you, and then you can start using one. So primer is really good. Whatever you apply on your skin, whether it is sunscreen, moisturizer or primer, you should ideally top it up with some kind of powder. For summers, your compact powders and your translucent powders are your friends. You have to keep them in your bags and you have to keep touching up your face with powders. So try and find out a nice compact which is closest to your skin color. You can completely avoid using foundations. That's totally fine because summer it's all about minimum makeup, least amount of layers on your skin. So you can just apply a primer and a compact and that's about it. So yeah, that's for the face. Another important thing is you have to use lip balm or lip conditioner in summer because although our skin is, you know, continuously oily, our lips tend to get dry in summers because of the dehydration. So lips tend to get dry and you have to keep moisturizing them or nourishing them. Try to find good lip conditioners, lip balms that suit you. I'll be listing a few below in this in the description box of this video, but I personally like Maybelline baby lips. If you all have heard, it's super accessible and very easily available in the market, and I really like that because once you apply it, this is one, so I have it here in front of me. So this is the Maybelline baby lips that I'm talking about. So this, especially this lip balm or lip conditioner, has a quality wherein even if you apply it, you can still apply a lipstick or a lip pencil on top of it. A lot of lip balms are so greasy that your pencil will not, you know, hold on the, it will be so oily that your pencil is not seen, lip color is not seen. So that's why I like the Maybelline one. Then the other one that I like is MAC. MAC lip conditioner comes in a flat dibby sort of a container. So I like that as well. That comes in a few colors. You can choose the color that you like to use. So that's another tip, that you should use a lip balm. You can go slightly casual in terms of the lip colors that you choose. You don't need to choose very heavy colors. You all can choose lighter colors, you all can choose nudes, and of course you can choose bright reds because that reds is all about warm and being summery. So if not nudes, then you can directly go to reds. So that's my recommendation on colors. So yeah, so this is about skincare and, you know, basic things on your face. Now when we move to makeup, I will recommend that you should use lighter colors, sheer colors, pastel colors. Don't go for intense dark colors like wine, maroon, dark brown. Don't go for these kind of colors. Try and go for soft browns, frosty pinks or pastel peach or these kind of colors. So these colors look really good in summer and they make your face look soothing and calming, and they give a cool touch to your face. So try and use pastel colors, whether it's on your eyeshadows or your blush. Don't go for heavier colors or intense colors. Like for lips, like I told you, stick to nudes or directly reds. I will also recommend using some vibrant colors in summer. So for example, if you have no makeup on your face and you're just having your compact powder and just a lip balm, you can just add a touch of blue eyeliner or a blue kajal pencil, and that looks really good in summers. So you can use vibrant colors in your makeups. We also use it when we do bridal makeup. We also add vibrant colors for summer weddings. So that is one very nice, interesting thing that you all can try. Just buy a blue colored eye pencil or a aqua green colored eye pencil, and you all can try and see how it looks. It looks really nice in summers. So now for some hair tips. So hair tips, I'll be dividing into hair care tips and hair styling tips. So in hair care, I recommend that if you all are oiling your hair regularly, if you all are like applying oil to your hair once a week, in summers, I recommend that do it maybe once in 2 weeks. So reduce the frequency of application of oil to your scalp, to your hair. So that is one tip. Secondly, your hair tends to get sweaty or oily very often. So start using dry shampoos. Dry shampoos are really good. Try and find out good brands that suit you for dry shampoos, and it's a magic product. It's brilliant. Sometime I'll definitely make a video on how to use a dry shampoo. But dry shampoos are basically alcohol based, and you just kind of spray them on your scalp and comb your scalp well, so that it just brings out all the oil and sweat and dust from your scalp. And without washing your hair, you can make your hair look non-sweaty and non-oily. So you can use dry shampoo. So basically, dry shampoo will help you in reducing the frequency of your hair wash, which is practically also it's easier if you don't have to wash your hair too often. And another thing is, you don't have to use shampoo conditioners too often on your hair. So dry shampoos is definitely a go-to product in summers. We have brilliant dry shampoo brands. I'll also add those brands in the description box below. So that is another thing. Thirdly, these two are the hair care tips that I can tell you guys. And the next is hair styling. So there's no limit in hair styling in summers, but it's more comfort oriented when it comes to styling, because a lot of people cannot, bear hair on their neck or, leaving hair open. So you can just tie your hair nicely. You can tie them in top knots. You can tie them into high ponytails. Try and make your ponytails look stylish. Try and make your ponytails look trendy by just, placing them high, maybe tying your, wrapping your hair around your ponytail. So there are a lot of tricks when you do that. Try using good accessories when you tie your hair, as in you can go for some decorative pins, you can go for good clutches, you can go for nice rubber bands, funky rubber bands. So try and focus on accessories, because if you don't want to leave your hair open, then might as well go all out with your accessories in the hair. So accessorize your hair nicely. You can use hairbands. Hairbands also keep hair away from your nape area, which is your sweaty area. So use hairbands which go all the way, below. Use fancy hairbands. Use those tie-up hairbands that, look good. So you can use hairbands. You can also go for braids in summers. You can go for the one-sided fishtail braids or simple braids. So braids also look really good. You can partially tie your hair into a top knot. That looks nice. So these are the styling tips. I'll also add or list all these in the description box so that you can, sort of refer to them later. So basically, for hair, you need to understand that your hair tends to become sweaty and oily very often. So try and style it such that, it doesn't look very flat and sticky. So that's what you have to take care about. So that's about hair. So I hope you all find these tips useful, and I hope you all follow them. Try and fill your vanities with good lip balms, good sunscreens, good primers, good compact powders. And one more last thing I would like to tell you is, at the end of the day in summers, again wash your face with cold water. And there are a lot of good face mists available in the market. I have a couple of them here. I can show you these. These are both these products are Lakme products. So this one is a toner. So it's a spray, basically. It's a spray and toner, and you don't have to apply it with your fingers, but this is a spray on toner, and it basically freshens up your skin, it cools down your skin, and also it closes the pores, which are generally opened because of the temperature of your skin or because of the cleansing that you've just performed. So this is a very nice product. You also get other toner sprays in the market. You can definitely try those. This is a brilliant product that I came across. This is Lakme Absolute Skin Gloss, which is a serum. So once you wash your face, you can apply this It's quite nice and soothing, and I found it very good for summers. So you can try and use these two products and, you know, keep your skin hydrated and moisturized and fresh. So yeah, so this is all about my summer tips. I hope you all enjoy following these tips, and I hope that makes your summer a little less terrible for you. So cool, enjoy, have fun. I'll come up with a nice video very soon. So keep watching. If you all enjoyed watching this video, please subscribe to my channel and leave your comments below. Also, don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you.